Alright, guys. So, passed out for lunch. But we'll be taking a look at the Libby's mod food, or food mod, I hope. I haven't seen much about the improved weather, like if I can make lightning happen or whatever on demand, or if it's just going to have the cool effects. Because it should have lightning and tornadoes and whatnot that's going on. I've also got the Roman weapons, so I figured this one here. I haven't gone looking for a new dragon mod just yet. I will, however. But it's just not yet. Anyway, fair to kind of go through and look at quite a few of the different weapon mods. Just kind of look at them, see what's going on in them, and see what might fit with the theme that I'm going for. I do, however, need to get some lights in here, and I need to stop saying that I need to do it, and I just need to do it. Because I actually picked a dark spot. So I did remove that dragons, the first dragons mod we were looking at. It only added some things in for, like a mount. Nothing to actually go and fight in the wild. So these are the Triceratops. This one here I think is the aberrant one. That one's the aberrant one. Kind of hard to tell during the day. So they have just two different versions of it. That one's going to glow at night. I like the aberrant versions of most things. The Woolly Rhino. You already know that that had a charge ability. They do also have taunts. And this one's the regular Packy. So as soon as you find like the animal you like a lot, you'd probably want to memorize it, you know, like which buttons, the taunt and stuff. Here's the Stig Imolach. I had to level that up because I was just too heavy when I was carrying all the saddles. So, other than having a slightly different look, it's pretty much the Packy. It's very nice. And this one looks amazing. Let's take a look at it. So these ones, they add a buff to all your animals. Somehow. I knew it. Jabs you with its own horns. Just not sure how to make it happen. But on the right, you see that little thumbprint? It's their little meter. On the Giga, it's the rage meter. And when that's maxed out, it's gonna turn on you. So they don't have identical stats. The aberrant versions to the regular. See, 360, 375. It's got the make everybody attack me thing. Let's level it up so we can see that stuff. So you'd want to put a whole bunch of health into one of these things if you're going to make everything attack it. Yep, rage. Everything's mad at it. And this one is Team Invisible. Oh, Team Cloak. And this particular animal is hidden right now. It's like a 20-second cooldown or something. And that Team Cloak is interesting. Because, see, it's not counting down on me. Tell you way over here, like out of the fuming range from all the animals. And then I come back close to him, and then it's gonna refresh it all the way back. And this is the aberrant Carno. It's got a headbutt. See, that first one was a headbutt. You can't do it again for like another 5 seconds. And I've noticed you stand on top of them when you dismount. It has been a while since I've actually owned a Carno again, because I've been doing a lot of roleplay servers and Carnos weren't permitted to be owned. Some pretty good range from that packy to this lady over here. Anyways, hey, you two, out is away. So these two are the these two are like the alphas that the game adds, this mod Exiles evolved or something like that? Let's see. Exiles of the Ark. So these, I've played around with it a few times on the Gunsmoke server. I haven't eaten all of them. Until now. They do some stuff. Some of them, anyway, do something to help out with one thing or another. So this one, I know what it does. Let's go with this one first. Nothing. Candy did something. I am a lot faster with that little candy buff there. Yeah, I did take that mod away because I didn't find much use in it. Pancakes don't do anything. Other than let you say you ate pancakes. Gliptodons, huh? Did it blink? Good, it blinks. So this in here is one you'd be able to actually tame, these versions here, compared to their primal or alpha versions over there. They do much more reasonable damage. Let's see, did you keep the 330, 300, 150? It's got a lower health on the aberrant deviations of things, because that was two different mods. Pancakes is just food. Does the same thing as a candy. Oh, that's the other mod. Let's go with 10 of these. So it says, a treat to make you feel just wonderful. And then the hot chocolate is keeping me warm. Meatloaf keeps you warm and filled up. And this one. You best do it. It's an experience booster. There it is. Takes a while, apparently. So we've delved into this one here briefly. It shows that there's a lot of people out in the wild. They don't work as a tribe. I'm probably going to look and see if I can get a different humanoid kind of mod working. One that'll let there be a couple of tribes, nothing like the old bush people where there's like 50 billion tribes and they all were way overpowerful and broke the game. But maybe just like something small where you feel like you can overpower them pretty easily. Like level 1, you don't want to stroll up into one. Level 10, you don't want to stroll up into one. But maybe level 20, you can stroll up in there and you can start taking out some of the sentries and then work your way into the middle or something like that. Eco trees, everybody knows and likes it. You put up some decorative trees and a variety of things. One downside to a lot of the eco role-playing stuff is you put a lot of trees out to make a place look magnificent and wonderful and kind of teleport you to a new land. What's going to happen is you're going to get a lot of lag because you got to load in every single little piece. Every single little flower, too. In the current just testings of things, the Exiles of Ark is just kind of one of them things. It does have a few decorative plants and stuff, that's nice. Consumables. Gender bender. Go switch something to a female or a male or whatever you need. So you can tame the Alpha Draconivir. Because there's a fertilized egg for one of them. It's this looking thing. I had this brilliant idea. What color am I gonna go with this season? With this testing doohickey? I I have never done just white and black. I've actually never played with the hazmat suits either. Never really cared to go up on the surface in aberration. There we go. Like the mad scientist working around here now. It's for science. Okay, weapons. Exiles of the Ark doesn't add weapons. They're all going to be primitive now. Those bottom ones I'm not taking care of right now. Some of these have some uses that I may not be currently aware of. Norman sword, they talk about all up and down saying, hey, that's the one that'll take out armored targets, which it does. I've had people test that one a lot. full health at 15:06. It didn't. There's my phone. Do some calculatings. So that did 89 points of damage. That's with the longbow and a regular flint arrow. This is with the regular arbalist. $13.92. That did 114 points of damage. Very nice. Did not. Come on. 1, 4, 4, 2 equals. It did 64 points of damage. Calculator ready. 1540 subtracts. $13.60. That one did 180 points of damage. That did 313 points of damage. Nice. Fold up. With the saddle on, it did only 281 points of damage. Alright. And then there's the flame arrows and stuff like that. Yeah, let's try it out. It's just for kicks. forgot to take it off. $12.90. $250. Increase that one from what did I say it was earlier? Oh, they've increased it. Was less than the regular one shot of the bodkin arrow, though. $247 on that one. That did 254 points of damage, so it did more damage than the other one did, but anyways, off with some melee weapons. I do want this one. Some of these have hidden abilities, like these two here. This one here does some it has a chance to bleed the target. And this one here does increase damage to armored targets. Let's see. Let's go with the dagger and axes first. So, you can hit it for 37, or you can toss it for 52. Huh, that's awesome. So this is one here, number two, the Noble Axe. It has, it's kind of like the Norman Sword, where it does increased damage to armored targets. This other one that I have equipped now is the Knight Axe. It has a 20% chance of causing an open wound. You can also use it to harvest stuff. So 18 points of damage for this, 14 for that one, 11 for this one, 10 points of damage, huh? Thank you. So this one does, what was it, 14 to a regular target. Six one nine, 179. 30 points of damage. It increased it. Let's just wait. So, Noble Axe, 30 points damage to said target. No bleeding effect. Oh, that one doesn't do bleeding effect anyway. Ignite Axe. 18. 1, 5, 8, 9. 20. Slightly increased, but it did also have armor on. 6, 9, subtract. About 11 points damage on that one. Alright, next up, yeah, let's do it. The Noble Axe did the most damage to the Fioma. After this test, we'll do these swords. Alright, I'm tired of this mask. They're all ones. Twenty-five points of damages. So that one. 22 points of torpor damages. So the Morning Star does the most. 25. So this one is the Norman sword. Definitely going to be good against that Fioma. Points of damage. And I have no points put into my melee damage. Fashion 31 1576 33. And at least 12 points of torpor damage. So this sword here looks like it's the king of the melee weapons here. This one's the king of the melee damage with 72 points of damage, the Norman sword. For that mod. That's the Castles and Keeps mod that added that stuff. Okay. Libby's food doesn't have any weapons. Right, armor, shields. I did forget to get these shields for comparison to this other mods of shields. Alright. Primitive Scutum version 1. This is the first version used by the Roman legions. If you couldn't guess, this is done by the Roman weapons mod. Okay, looks nice. Does 738. Mm. better than the Berserker shield. Looks a little bit more Viking-like. However, the castles and keeps ones whoop it. Whoop all of them. Anyway, let's go look at them. So this one is the Skyrim version 2. See a little bit of differences. This is the Ekviti cohort. Definitely much nicer paintings on the shields and stuff. And then here's the Berserker shield from the castles and keeps. The tower shield. Paint those there. Let's see if I can paint them too. That X is the pattern. Cannot paint that one. Not that one neither. I would love to be able to paint them. So, as far as shields go, castles and keeps have won it by simply being, well, first, better. Second, you can paint them. See, it's changing some stuff. See, look at that. Tower shield, 1581, okay. Does have a luck of the draw, but that's a huge difference for being primitive. So these ones easily whoop to those ones, and they're lighter, so they win. Let's take a look at the light pilum, heavy pilum, and the gladius. Do you want me to cook a hot dog? You guys may not be able to read it. So this is one. This one here is the light pilum. Light Roman pilum used against targets further away. Romans use this when approaching or defending against the enemy before engaging in close combat. 14 points of damage. No points of damage. This one is the heavy pylum. Heavy pylum, stronger and more damage, but less range. And it also stacks. Here's the Gladius. 38. Nice. Come here, piggy. Full health. Reset calculator. I don't think a whole lot of people will watch these beginning ones, because that's when we're going through and doing a lot of this stuff. We're not able to have it like fine-tuned already for everybody. Equals 41 points of damage, not bad. It comes in right after the Norman sword. Let's see what this one says. The Roman Gladius was the standard weapon within the Roman legions. Shorter than most, but extremely effective. And it looks pretty cool. There's the size comparison. Okay, are you filled up? Almost. Come on, wake up. Resetting calculator. 1609. Subtract. Oh, book it up there. 1576. 1576 equals 33 points of damage. 609. Subtract. Now let's see about the other one. Ooh. 1567, 1567 equals. Oops, doubled that one. 1567. 42 points of damage. What was that sword at again? Points of damage. So that spear nearly does the same amount of damage as this Gladius. Wah, wah, yeah. Oh, it'd be kind of cool if, like, you take the swipe down to the right, then you just kind of swivel it back and just kind of do, like, an upward thrust against them again. You know? But that's kind of like martial arts stiffs. So that's the Roman weapons. Now into the Power Hammer and Legendary Items version 6.0. Now let's get this. This will be real easy. The Battle Scythe and the Great Sword. Two different mods for both things. It's kind of annoying. But anyways, let's first do these two. So you came in right below that. You would do the far most damage with the Bodkin arrow. Go away. I added the sword. Maybe I misclicked on that sword. Grit sword, grits. Tools. There we go. So, you ready to have a look at him? Oh, yeah. And it lets you keep the shield out. It's pretty awesome. So, let's see. This battle scythe. the harvesting tool of King Pulterius himself, unstoppable for harvesting resources and your enemy's skulls. I'm not going to calculate that one. This one here is the Great Sword, the legendary weapon of King Batista, jointly forged by smiths of the three great kingdoms in celebration of Unification Day and the birth of Princess Emma. Unrivaled on the battlefield and a masterwork of bladecraft. So this one probably does a lot of like harvesting and not really a battle scythe. Let's take a look at it. Holy shnikes, that sucker's huge. Should look like I need two hands to wield it. How close? Come here, piggy! Subtract 1442. That also did far superior torpidity damage. Let's see, does it have any other effects? Okay. Oh. I was like, it didn't even bleed yet. You ready for the numbers? So it did like 80 torpor per swing. And it did 167 damage. Far above the Norman sword. Okay, little piggy. Sleep it off. That sword is way too powerful for the ideal we're going for here. Alright, what's next on the list? Ah, yes. Power hammer and legendary forge items. So all these things from the video I watched would be made from here. Resources, be the Talon. Apparently that's its own resource, not the generic Arc one. Weapons and tools. AOS, Axe of Slaying. Hob, Hammer of Bashing, what the heck? She's out of sight, Sword of Slaying. Flanged Mace. Hammer Mace? I just call that a sledgehammer. Obsidian Axe of Slaying. Obsidian Hammer Mace. Fire Wyvern Mace. Ooh. Those look cool. Let me get a new piggy. I'm recording, so everybody can hear everything. I can't mute it. I love you. That's better. $16.09, fancy that. I do want to try something quick. Not particularly keen. Back to the shop. So in hey, why is that journeyman? Apprentice? Ascendant? We'll do these four first, and then we'll do those four next. It's got a purple blade, that's nice. Testing their swings. A green? What the heck is this game trying to do to me? Well, the mod. No quality. Ramshackle. That's kinda, you know? There, primitive, thank you. Man. And I thought that sword was broken. We're just going to take a look at this mod, because why not? These weapons look amazing. Whoa, it lifted it up. At least 1,000 points of damage. And that sound effect's pretty awesome. So this mod is way overpowered for what I'm going for. This one's pretty sweet. And this is where you'd make those devices from. Don't particularly care where I place it, because it's not going to live very long. Phew. It looks amazing. Guy did a lot of work. Made these look cool. Realistic. It's just, if I can nerf them, that'll make this a valuable thing for it. Let's see, what was it called again? Okay, so it's the Power Hammer and Legendary Items mod version 6.0. And it lists some stuff. Does it have eye and eye is what I want to know. No. But So the obsidian stone hammer hits less than the regular stone hammer, it looks like. And it also takes a little extra to knock out a level 20 Inky. A lot of these even do some special things. But it's just... it's a lot for what I'm going for. This would be more of a PvE only situation here. That's next up on the list. Carts and wagons. Creatures? It's mine! This mod might be a little unfortunately broken. So this is what it's supposed to do. Be like a little ceiling tile, you can go put some storage up on it. then you can carry far more than normal. Which I like. Again. They've lost it. Oh. Oh, really? Stuck. That's good to know. You can flip this thing. Goodbye. Room wind. Any other mods on my current list at this current time? So the carts and wagons, very cool. Just needs a little more work before it can be used here. With the other mods, well, with anything. Because even the generic Drake was trying to kill it. Alright. Let us stop with this episode for now. I want to remove these mods. And find some more mods. To try and fill the needs. Anyways, you guys have a good one.